Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Jai Shri Gurudev ki. We will not have much opportunity to do this. One more day. Welcome to the last but one day for the 14th annual festival of Bhakti Yoga in Houston. We have just one little announcement, that is for the benefit of the temple. We sold 2 G clays of Shamarani Didi, and only 2 are left. 2 G clays of Shamarani Didi signed by Srila Gurudev. Only 2 are left, so we are giving 50% off. 50% off. Padmanabha is taking 1. They are the book cover print, book cover picture of. Gaur Prabhanand is book cover of Prem Samput and Chamatkar Chandrika. We'll make a deal with you.
Jai Jai Shri Radhe.
Ajnan Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalaka Chakshur Militangena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Tavai vasmi najivami tvaya vina iti vijñaya Radhe tame mam. Party obeisance and in the lotus feet of life. Paramartha sam guru par par mani charida pravishto Vishnu pada sutta sasma bhakti pragyan sabur swami. And same in the lotus feet of my Shiksha Guru. Nitya Lila Pravishtam Vishnu Pada Sutta Shishmar Bhakti. Vedant Swami Maharaj Ji. My dear Sannyasis, Brahmacharis, Vaishnav and Vaishnavi. Krishna became some bigger. And as you heard yesterday, that Krishna with his followers, Gwalbal, he used to go to the houses of Gopi, motherly mood Gopis, and anyhow to steal butter, milk or anything in their houses. And how we began to do problem for them. They began to tell, complain, Mother Yashoda, your Lala has become very naughty. You should control. But all gopis were happy that Krishna was going in his house. They wanted, they had austerities for this. But they know that Yashoda, Mother Yashoda does not know anything about Krishna, these sweet pastimes. So, they pretending the complaint, they used to tell Mother Yashoda. Mother Yashoda only laughing, something telling, but see in the end, for My house butter is not sweet. And that is why Krishna goes to other gopis' house and there he stones and takes. Better I should milk myself, my cows, Thavali, Shyamali, Surabhi, and myself, I should make yogurt and churn. So decided this, and that very day was Deepavali. Mother Yashoda sent all his head servants to their houses to make Deepavali, and alone she was in house and churning house. She was so beautiful that you can think that how beautiful Krishna coming from her womb. Same color, though sometimes somewhere it is written that Yashoda was of golden color, but not, just like Krishna color. So Krishna blessed, this color came for Mother Yashoda and tuned from the neck of Mother Yashoda came in the neck of Krishna. So Krishna sings so well. So Mother Yashoda was chanting and observing his sweet pastimes, his boyhood sweet pastimes, and chanting Govinda Dhamo Dharma Veti Govinda Dhamo Dharma Veti Govinda Dhamo Dharma Veti Govinda Dhamo Dharma Veti. So after this, Prem Priyajan will explain what happened.
Hello. चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकै तदाहले कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः. First of all, after my Sastangana Pushpanjali, thousands of times at the lotus feet of my holy master, Asmadeya Paramarajatama Guru Padma, Om Vishnu Pada Shtotara Satasisimat, Srila Bhakti Vedanta Narayana Goswami Maharaj. Secondly, after my pranam thousands of times at the lotus feet of my Sirupanuga Gaudiya Guru Parampara, and after my pranam to Anandya Jagandhi Padgan and all the assembled Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis. Srila Gurudev ordered me to elaborate upon this beautiful pastime, Dham Bhajan Leela of Sri Krishna, that has been described so wonderfully by Sri Shukadev Goswami in Srimad Bhagavatam and expanded even more beautifully by our Gaudiya Acharyas such as Srila Jiva Goswami and Srila Vishwachakra Thakur in their commentaries. So as we heard from the lotus lips of Srila Gurudev, Mother Yashoda, she was thinking that my friends, they come to my house and they complain to me that my child is going to their house to steal butter. It may be that the butter in their house tastes better than the butter in my house. But if I were to make the butter myself with so much love, then Krishna, he'll be satisfied and he won't have to go and steal from door to door makan, butter, and mishri. So Mother Yashoda, she milked the cow Padmaganda. Her milk is so fragrant, it smells like lotus flowers. And from this milk she made yogurt, and then on the early morning of Deepavali, she began to churn this yogurt and make butter for Sri Krishna. So how Mother Yashoda was so beautiful. She is very healthy. and her bangles are jingling together like cartels, and the churning rod is moving in the yogurt, diktan, diktan, making a sound like a mridanga as she's singing kirtan of Krishna's name, form, qualities and pastimes, completely absorbing remembrance of her child. So if anyone would do kirtan, then Sri Krishna is attracted. So Sri Krishna, he was lying asleep on the bed of Mother Yashoda. And Mother Yashoda had placed his hands on top of a pillow, so that Krishna would be lying there asleep thinking, my mother is here. But when he started to wake up, he was feeling around. And then he realized, oh, it's not my mother, it's a pillow. And he was hungry, he wanted to drink her breast milk. So he got down from the bed, and he was so small, so it was difficult for him. He slid down backwards on his stomach, onto the ground, and then began to come out from that room to the place where Mother Yashoda was churning the yogurt. So as Krishna came, he looked so beautiful, quite naked, only wearing a chain of bells around his waist. And his mother has put kajal, black kajal, on his eyes, but now he's crying. And some of the tears are mixing with the black kajal and making a black stream down his face and down his belly. And on the other side, he's rubbed the kajal from his eye with his hand. So the tears without kajal are running this side. So two rivers, one white and one black, like the Ganga and Jamuna, and they're mixing together in his belly button, Sriveni Prayag. And in this way, Krishna is stumbling, rubbing his eyes, crying, calling for his mother. Oh, Maya, Amma. Amma means mother. This is the first words that Krishna spoke. Amma, Amma, Amma. This is why the first word of all the Vedas is Om. Because it is the first word of the Supreme Lord calling. Amma, 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 calling his mom. So, Krishna, he was loudly calling for his mother, but Mother Yashoda, she could not hear because she was absorbed in Krishna Nam and churning the yogurt. She looked so beautiful. She was dressed in silk. And this silk was so fine, that you could fold it over 10 times. And even fold it over 10 times, it would still fit underneath your fingernail. So being dressed in such fine silk, and her beauty was peeping out through the silk. And she was churning and singing the names of Sri Krishna. In this way, Sri Krishna gradually approached his mother, and he put one hand on the churning rod, and with another hand he pulled on her veil. Then Mother Yashoda came out from her absorption in Krishna and saw Sri Krishna, from one absorption in Krishna to another. So then Krishna was there and pulling on her veil because he was eager to drink her breast milk. So then Mother Yashoda, she took Krishna into her lap and gave him her breast, and she beheld the beautiful face of her child taking her breast milk. At that moment, tears began to stream from her eyes, and bhakti became bhakti rasa. Bhakti and bhakti rasa are not the same thing. But when vibhav, anubhav, sattvik bhav, and vyabhachari bhav, five rasa samagri, ingredients of masa, rasa, mixed together, then it becomes bhakti rasa. And one of the sattvik bhavs that Mother Yashoda has, which is only there in Vatsalya Ras, is the streaming of milk from her breast. This is a current of Vatsalya Prem, and Krishna was tasting that love. But in the meantime, Mother Yashoda looked and saw that on the stove there was milk that was boiling, and now this milk was about to boil over. Why? Because the milk was thinking, alas, my life is useless. Because Krishna's belly is unlimited. In his belly, there are all the universes are there, in the belly of Krishna. And at the same time, the breast milk of Mother Yashoda is also unlimited, because it is greater than Kheer Sagar, the ocean of milk, because it is the ocean of her Vatsalya Prem. So her milk is unlimited, his belly is unlimited, this drinking will go on forever. When will I get a chance to do some seva? So the milk, he felt, oh, like Narottam Das Thakur has written, Kenova achaye prana ki sukalagiyo Narottama dasa keno nagelo moriya. If I have no chance to serve Sri Krishna, why do I stay alive? There's no need to live in this world. And in this way, the milk jumped out of the pot and was going into the fire. committing suicide on the pretext of boiling over. Seeing this, Mother Yashoda, she was very kind. She put down Krishna and went to save the milk. So here Mother Yashoda is like Guru. The Guru has complete happiness, totally perfect, self-satisfied in his service to the divine couple. Yet still, seeing that another living entity is crying, being bereft of the opportunity to serve Sri Krishna, then Sri Guru puts aside his own bhajan and reaches out towards those living entities and gives them an opportunity to serve also. So Mother Yashoda, she was going to give this milk an opportunity to serve. Now, Sri Krishna, he's very strong. Now he's about 2.5 years old. But when he was only 6 days old, Putana, who has the strength in her arms of 60,000 elephants, she had Krishna on her breast, and she said, "Child, leave me, leave me." But she could not get Krishna off her breast, even having the strength of 60,000 elephants, when Krishna was only 6 days old. But now Krishna is 2.5. He's much stronger. And he's holding on to the breast of Mother Yashoda with both hands. He's holding on to her body with both legs and holding on as tight as he can with his mouth. And Krishna was applying all of his force. But Mother Yashoda very easily, with one hand, with the left hand, just said, "Sit down," and put him there. He was helpless. Because see, Krishna is completely overpowered by the brain of Mother Yashoda. So she set off and she sprinkled water on the milk to stop the milk from boiling over. Now one may say, Krishna is upset. What kind of bhakti is this? But is bhakti about how to upset Krishna? No. Bhakti is for the benefit of Krishna. So even though Krishna was upset, she thought, from my breast milk, I cannot make yogurt, I cannot make sandesh, I cannot make sweet rice. So Krishna likes all of these things, so I should go and save the milk. So even though Krishna was upset, Mother Yashoda went and took care of the milk. In the meantime, Krishna, his face was red. He stamped his foot. He bit his lip in anger. Oh, why did she do that? I'll teach my mother a good lesson. So he saw that there was a pestle for grinding spices. And he took that pestle and he looked at the big pot of yogurt that she was churning. He knew that the top of the pot is thick, but the bottom part is somewhat thin. And he took the pestle and he threw it at the pot of yogurt and it made a hole. But what happens if you make a hole in the bottom, then by the pressure, all the yogurt sprays out like a hose. And yogurt sprayed out across the kitchen. Krishna was amazed. How beautiful. There's yogurt everywhere in the kitchen. He was very happy. But then the next moment he thought, uh-oh, when my mother comes and sees this mess, I'll be in trouble. So it's time to leave the scene of the crime. So then Krishna, he thought he should make himself scarce, and he left. In the meantime, Mother Yashoda came back and saw that the kitchen was in a mess. There was yogurt everywhere. And she thought, where did Krishna go? And then she noticed something. Even though Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, He's omniscient, omnipresent and all-pervading. In Vrindavan, He is covered by the prema of His devotees. He has forgotten that He's Supreme Lord. He thinks He's the son of Mother Yashoda. So even though He thought He would escape, what did He do? Like a small child, inadvertently, he walked through the yogurt. And the yogurt was all over his feet. So he left a trail of yogurty footprints all the way to his hiding place. So just as a policeman knows how to find the criminal by looking at the clues, Mother Yashoda, she saw the footprints and she began to follow them. Following the footprints, she came to a door to a storeroom that was little open and she peered in. When she looked inside, she saw that Krishna had climbed onto the top of a grinding mortar and he had reached up to take butter from a pot. And he was feeding this butter to so many monkeys and also crows. Why was Krishna feeding the monkeys? Because in his previous incarnation as Lord Ramachandra, so many monkeys helped him build a bridge across to Lanka and invade Lanka and return with Sita to Ayodhya. But at that time, the Lord Ram, he was a resident of the forest. He didn't have anything to feed the monkeys or reward them. So now in this incarnation, Krishna was thinking, oh, now I will feed you all. And he was feeding butter to the monkeys and also to the crows because they came in the dynasty of Kakabhoshandi, who also helped Lord Ram. So Mother Yashoda saw, oh my child, he's so naughty, feeding the crows and the monkeys. I'll catch him. And she took a stick in her hand to chastise him. And she began to sneak up on Krishna. So you know that a cat knows the art of how to walk, even on dry leaves, without making a rustling sound. So Madhya Yashoda, with a stick in her hand, she began to walk like a cat, very gently, in the direction of Krishna, whose back was turned towards her. As Krishna was feeding the monkeys and the crows, just as Madhya Yashoda became very close to him, the monkeys, they began to run away. The crows began to fly away. And Krishna thought, why are they leaving? It must be because there's someone behind me. And just as Madhya Yashoda was about to catch him, Krishna realized that someone was behind him. And he jumped down from the grinding mortar and began to run. So Madhya Yashoda was running after Krishna. And Krishna was running in a zigzag way. So that Madhya Yashoda, who was somewhat healthy, as they say, she was unable to keep up with him. So then Krishna saw that there was another door, the outer door that led outside into the road. And he thought, my mother, she's very chaste. So she's not all dressed and decorated in such a way that she should be seen in public. So if I go out into the street, then my mother will be too shy to follow me. So surely I'll be safe. So Krishna, he ran outside. So Madhya Yashoda running after him came to the door and then she paused. I shouldn't go out dressed like this. But anyway, it's Diwali, everyone's at home. There's no one moving around in the street. I'll go anyway and catch him. So then Madhya Yashoda, she ran out and she was chasing Krishna. So as she was running after Krishna, she said, hey you, Bandar Bandhu, friend of a monkey. Why did you break the pot? Who broke the pot? He said, oh mother, I didn't break the pot. You broke the pot. You have very big nupur, ankle bells, and when you got up to run away, your ankle bell hit the pot, and the pot was broken. She said, who was feeding the monkeys? Krishna said, he who created the monkeys feeds the monkeys. It's true. So Krishna was very cheeky. So finally Mother Yashoda, she took her stick and she drew it back like this as if she were to throw it at Krishna. And Krishna flinched and covered himself. And then Mother Yashoda, she had the chance. With her left hand, she took Krishna's right hand. And in her right hand, she raised her stick. So Krishna, being a little baby, he ran behind her legs like this. So she couldn't hit him. And he was very much afraid. Rudantam moho netra yugmam rijantam karamboja yugmena satanka netram. See, Krishna was breathing heavily, tears coming from his eyes, rubbing his eyes again and again. And his eyes are filled with fear of his mother. All the scriptures say, Apada sansitim goran yanna ma viva sokrinan tatasa jo vimucheta yad vibeti swayam vayam. This world is full of fear. But fear personified is afraid of the name, even the name of Krishna. But Krishna himself, he's afraid of Madhya Yashoda. What shall she do? Lord Brahmaji, he said, Pantastu koti sata vatsara sampragamyo vayor tapi manaso muni pungyavanam. The great rishis and yogis who can travel at the speed of the wind or at the speed of mind for thousands of years, they are unable to catch the Achincha Tattva, Sri Krishna. He is inconceivable and beyond the reach of the mind and senses. But Madhya Yashoda, she could do what all the great yogis could not do and catch Krishna. She could catch the Supreme Lord because of the power of her love. So then, Madhya Yashoda, seeing the fear in Krishna's eyes, she thought, oh, I should not punish him with a stick. Because if he gets too afraid, if he's too much traumatized, then when he grows up, he'll be maladjusted and there'll be many problems in his life. So Madhya Yashoda, she put the stick aside and she thought, his partner in crime was the grinding mortar. He stood on the grinding mortar in order to take the butter. So the grinding mortar is Krishna's accomplice. So I should tie the two of them together. And then I can go about my housework and Krishna, he'll be limited. So the area in which he can commit his mischief will be somewhat limited. So then Madhya Yashoda, she took Krishna and she took a rope and she tried to put the rope around Sri Krishna's waist. But when she put it around his waist, it was two fingers too short. So she took another rope and tied it together and again put it around his waist Again, it was two fingers too short. She told her sakis, "Oh, bring from your houses your ropes." So her sakis bought their ropes. She tied them all together. Always it was two fingers too short. The significance of this is that Shri Krishna cannot be bound unless one does sadhana, his own practices. But even sadhana will not be enough. The other finger is kripa, the grace of the Lord. When our sadhana is very intense, and when the Lord's mercy is placed on top of that, then Krishna allows himself to be bound. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he met some pandits of the Sri Sampradaya, and they were quarreling with each other. Some were saying everything depends on mercy of God, and others were saying everything depends on sadhana. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, "No, it is just like if you have fallen in a well, you cannot get out. If someone gives a rope in that well, if you hold on to the rope very tightly, but they don't pull, you stay in the well. If they pull the rope but you don't hold on, then you also stay in the well. But if you hold on tightly and they also pull, then you can get out." So in the same way, if a devotee makes very determined and persistent endeavors in the practice of bhakti yoga, that is like holding on to the rope, then the mercy of Guru and Krishna will come, and that devotee will be lifted beyond the material world to Goloka Vrindavan. So this is the significance of two fingers. Sadhana and kripa both are required. So for many hours Madhya Yashoda was trying to bind him, and her sakis were laughing. They said, "Oh, it is not written on your forehead that you can bind your son." But Madhya Yashoda was thinking, "Oh, he is not more intelligent than me. He is my baby, he came from my womb. I must bind him." She made a very strong vow, greatly determined. So when the devotee is greatly determined, and Krishna sees that they are endeavoring again and again, then his mercy comes. So Shukadeva Goswami said, "Drishtva Parashramam Krishna Kripaya Sitsavandane." Seeing that Madhya Yashoda's face was red, that she was becoming tired, that she was covered with drops of perspiration, Krishna's heart melted. And then Madhya Yashoda, just taking one small rope from her hair, put it around Krishna's waist and bound him to the grinding mortar. Now the job was done. She went to take care of her housework.
Vishnu will translate. You so translate, I will speak in Hindi. Jab Yashoda Maiya, Krishna ko baandh diya. Socha ki abhi nahi baandhenge, to kahi Yamuna mein nahi gir jaye, kahi ban mein nahi chala jaye. तब तक मैं घर का काम कर लूं और ये शांत हो जाएगा, फिर इसको बंधन खोल करके और इसको स्तन दूंगी। इतने में बलदेव जो उपानंद जी के घर गए थे, वे रोहिणी मैया के साथ में आए। बलदेव जी ने पूछा, "अरे कृष्ण को बांधा कौन?" बड़े जोश मैंने क्रोधित होकर के बोले, "जो कोई होगा उसे हम मैं दंड दूंगा." श्रीराम ने कृष्ण के बलदेव जी के कान में कहा, "जो शोधा मैया ने बांधा, तब तो वो शांत हो गए उनका क्रोध, जब शोधा मैया के सामने कुछ नहीं चलेगा, शांत हो गए। कृष्ण अब तक तो रो रहे थे, अब आंख के आंसू सूख गए हैं, किंतु काजल की धारा यहां तक सब भरा पड़ा है, मुख ऐसे ऐसे करते करते। देखो सुप्रीम लॉर्ड, लॉर्ड ऑफ द लॉर्ड, और बात मैया यशोदा के डर से रोते हैं, ये यशोदा जी की वात्सल्य भावना है। कृष्ण ने कहा, उनको उसी समय में स्मरण हुआ, नारद जी ने कुबेर के दो पुत्रों को नल कुमार और मणि गुरु को भी संपात दिया है, वृक्ष योनि में जाओ और कृष्ण द्वापर युग के अंत में जब आएंगे तो तुम्हारे उनके स्पर्श से तुम्हारा उद्धार हो जाएगा, भक्ति भी होगी। उस समय में जेहू उनको क्या सत्याभिधातुम निज भक्त भाषितुम, उन्होंने कहा बच्चों को ये तुम लोग खेलो वो कर लो और मैं चल रहा हूं आंगन से बाहर जा करके हम लोग खेलेंगे। तब सखाओं ने पीछे से ओखल को टहलना आरंभ किया और ये भी आगे बढ़े। जब द्वार से निकलना ही था उसी समय में दो अर्जुन के वृक्ष एक साथ जड़े एक साथ और फिर अलग अलग हो गए। कृष्ण उस पार तो चले गए, ओखल रह गई इधर में। कृष्ण ने थोड़ा सा जोर लगाया, स्पर्श ही मात्र किया तो कृष्ण से वृक्षों का संपर्क नहीं हुआ, वो तो ओखल कृष्ण से रस्सी का संपर्क और रस्सी से ओखल का संपर्क और ओखल के द्वारा ज्यों ही दोनों वृक्ष स्पर्श से उनका हुआ त्यों बड़े जोर से और गिर पड़े। जब गिर पड़े तो बड़ा जोर से शब्द हुआ, जो जहां था वहीं से दौड़ा। नंद बाबा ब्रह्मांड घाट में स्नान करने के लिए गए थे, वहीं से दौड़े। मैया यशोदा ने देखा कि कृष्ण कहां, कृष्ण तो है नहीं, कहां गया है, आज ये विपत्ति कहां से आ गई। वो भी वहां से दौड़ी, सब गोपियां जितनी भी थी जो जिधर थे उधर से वहीं पर पहुंच गया। हाँ, ट्रांसलेट।
ओम ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। सो श्री गुरुदेव इज एक्सप्लेनिंग दैट मदर यशोदा हैड बाउंड कृष्णा सो दैट ही मे नॉट गो एंड फॉल और जंप इन रिवर जमुना बिकॉज ही वॉज रनिंग इन द स्ट्रीट्स ऑफ गोकुल और ही माइट गो एंड गेट लॉस्ट इन द फॉरेस्ट बिकॉज ही इज रनिंग अराउंड। सो शी थॉट लेट मी बाइंड हिम for some time and in the meantime I will also finish my household work and he will also get pacified and calm down. So and after that once he is pacified I will release him from his bondage and then I will also feed him. So at that time Baldev he had gone to Upanand's home with Nand Maharaj and he had with Rohini Maiya he had gone to Upanand's home. So he returned back and then when he saw that Krishna was bound he became very very angry and then asked who has bound Krishna. So no one was able to answer but Sri Ram slowly came and whispered in his ears Mother Yashoda, and when he heard this he became absolutely calm down because now he could also not say anything. So Krishna so far was crying but by this time his tears had also dried and there were two long streaks of kajal through his down his cheeks. So he at that time remembered that the two sons of Narad Manigrib and Nalkuber had been cursed. Kuber had been cursed that and they because had been cursed by Narad ji and as a result they became trees in the courtyard of Nand Maharaj. So he remembering this he wanted to deliver them, so he asked his friends to drag the mortar so they could go out in the street and play. So the friends went behind the mortar and they pushed Krishna, and Krishna also started crawling. And then when he was almost at the end of the courtyard, coming out of the house, there were these two trees and the mortar got stuck between the two trees, and with a huge sound, both the trees fell down. So Gurudev is explaining that Krishna was not directly touching, he did not directly touch the trees. He was touching the rope, and the rope was bound to the mortar, and it was a mortar which stuck the trees. But by little effort, he didn't make any special effort, but just little effort, and both these trees came down. So because of this tumultuous sound, huge big sound, Anand Baba, who was at Brahmand Ghat, he heard this and wondered where the sound is coming from, and he rushed back to his home. And Yashoda ji and other gopis also got very terrified and came out looking where the sound was coming from.
अब तक कृष्ण बच्चों के साथ में हंस रहे थे, खेल रहे थे, किंतु नंद बाबा जब आए तो नंद बाबा को देखकर बड़े जोर से रोने लगे। नंद बाबा देखा जैसे ये क्या पेड़ ये गिरे हुए हैं, आंधी भी नहीं थी, तूफान भी नहीं था, कुछ भी नहीं था, और ये ऐसे गिरे हैं। यदि ऐसे गिरते तो कृष्ण उसी में चिपट जाता, मारा जाता। उनका हृदय धड़क रहा था और कृष्ण के निकट आए। कृष्ण तो खूब जोर से लंबी लंबी सांसें ले रहे। कृष्ण को उन्होंने गोदी में बैठाया और बैठा करके पूछा, कौन बांधा, बतलाओ कौन बांधा। तो कृष्ण ने कहा, मैया ने बांधा। मैया ने बांधा, बड़ी निष्ठुर है तो उसे मैं मारूंगा। जब कृष्ण ने हाथ पकड़ लिया, इसके बाद में उनका अपने पॉकेट से लड्डू निकाला और कृष्ण को दे दिया, और धीरे 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 उनका बंधन खोला। पहले सखाओं ने खोलने की बड़ी चेष्टा की थी, मदमंगल आगे आया, मैं खोल देता हूं, बदमंगल नहीं खोल सका, तो सुबल उसे धक्का देकर मैं खोलूंगा, वो भी नहीं। इसके बाद में सीताम, सुबल, मधुमंगल, अर्जुन, लवंग, किंकर इत्यादि बहुत सब सखाया है, कोई भी खोल नहीं सका। वात्सल्य रस का बंधन सखे और दास्य रस के सेवकों के द्वारा संभव पर नहीं है, नहीं खोल सके। और नंद बाबा ने क्या किया, वात्सल्य रस का बंधन वात्सल्य ही रस खोल सकता है, इसलिए धीरे धीरे खोल दिया। बोले, बांधा कौन, तो मैया, खोला कौन, बाबा। अब कुछ प्रश्न जो जोर जोर से लंबी सांसें ले रहे थे, अब धीरे धीरे कम हो गया, केवल सुषुप्ते रहे, सुषुप्ता इस तरह से सांस ले रहे। मैया यशोदा काठ की पुतली के समान में देख रही है दूर से, निकट आने का साहस नहीं है, सोच रहे थे ये आज यदि ये पेड़ों में दब करके मर जाता तो आज क्या होता, मेरे लिए ये सब हुआ, इसलिए न बोल रही है न रो रही है, आंख के आंसू भी सूख गए हैं, काठ की पुतली की तरफ में खड़ी है। नंद बाबा ने धीरे धीरे कृष्ण को एक कंधे पर बैठाया और बलदेव को एक कंधे पर बैठाया और ब्रह्मांड घाट गए और ब्रह्मांड घाट जाकर के स्नान किया, बच्चों को भी स्नान किया, कृष्ण को अच्छी तरह से मलमल करके स्नान कराया और गौशाला में गए। गौशाला में जाकर के अपने पॉकेट से मिश्री कृष्ण के या बलदेव के मुख में दे दिया और गायों से घर घर दूध मुख में भर देते और वो पेट भर थारोष्ण दूध एकदम पेट भर करके पिला दिया। इसके बाद में घर आए, घर आते आते प्रातः शाम हो गई, आज घर में रसोई नहीं बनी है, सभी भूखे हैं, कृष्ण को केवल दूध और बलदेव को दूध पिला दिया है। जब घर आए तो दोनों को बैठा दिया, एक को बाएं तरफ एक तरफ में दाएं तरफ। इतने में उपानंद के घर से रूही मई आई थी, उनकी पत्नी आई थी और बूढ़ी जो स्त्रियां थी माता की भांति वाली, वे सभी कृष्ण के पास में गई। उन्होंने देखा ये यशोदा की जैसी स्थिति है, अब तो तब तो मरने वाली है, इसलिए इसको किसी प्रकार से कृष्ण को ला करके इसको बचाना है। इसलिए वे नंद बाबा और कृष्ण बलराम के पास में गए। रोहिणी मैया ने बलदेव जी को कहा जाओ उसको खेस करके पकड़ लाओ कृष्ण को। बलदेव जी गए और पकड़ा, तब ही राम ने ऐसा कृष्ण ने ऐसा थक्का दिया कि एकदम गिर पड़े और ऐसे देखते रह गए, तो मुझसे भी आज बलवान हो गया। इसके बाद में उपानंद की पत्नी और रोही मैया निकट में आई, बेटा चलो चलना नहीं तो मैया तुम्हारी बड़ी दुखी है, तो नहीं जाऊंगा, नहीं जाएगा तो किसके साथ में खेलेगा, तो ताऊ भैया के साथ में और बाबा के साथ में खेलूंगा, खाएगा क्या, बाबा मिश्री और भारोषण खिला देंगे, तो तू जाएगा नहीं, तो नहीं जाऊंगा, नहीं जाऊंगा। रोहिणी मैया ने कहा बेटा नहीं जाएगा तो तुम्हारी मैया तुम्हारे लिए जय सिया राम हो जाएगी, तो तब क्या करेगा, जब ही सुने जय सिया राम मैंने मर जाएगी, तो वही मैया मैया कहते हुए हाथ ऐसे लंबा बढ़ा दिया। उस समय में कृष्ण रोने लगे मैया मैया, नंद बाबा भी कृष्ण का भाव देख करके मैया मैया वो भी रोने लगे। रोहिणी उपानंद की स्त्री जो वहां पर था सब भाव में विभोर होकर के रोने लगा। इस प्रकार के कृष्ण को ले आकर के मैया यशोदा के गोदी में ले दिया। यशोदा मैया अब तक तो प्राणहीन होकर के चुपचाप थी काठ की पुतली की तरह, जब कृष्ण को गोदी में पाया अब तो बिलख बिलख करके खूब जोरों से रोने लगे। तो इस प्रकार से जब रसोई बनी, रोहिणी ने कुछ संक्षेप में बनाया, तो नंद बाबा वहां पर बैठे बलदेव को दाऊ को लेकर के प्रसाद पाने के लिए। उन्होंने कहा कि कृष्ण अपनी मैया को पकड़ लाओ, मैया नहीं रही थी आज परोसने के लिए, तो कृष्ण गए उसका आंचल पकड़ करके किसी प्रकार से पकड़ करके ले आए। नंद बाबा और कृष्ण ने प्रसाद पाया, इसके बाद जो सब लोगों ने प्रसाद पाया, बोलो मादर यशोदा की। कृष्ण कन्हैया की जय, ताऊ भैया की जय, कौ प्रमाण।
So, Nand Baba, he came back and he saw that these two huge trees had fallen down, and he was wondering that no big storm came, there were no strong winds, so how is it these two trees fell down? And then he saw that Krishna was on the other side, and he got so terrified, what if these trees would have fallen on the same side as Krishna was? Krishna was breathing very heavily, and then he slowly took Krishna and put him in his lap and asked him, who had bound you? So Krishna said, mother, Maya. So he said, oh, she is so nishthur, so stone-hearted, I will go and beat her. So Krishna immediately held the hand of Nand Baba, indicating, no, please don't beat Maya. So Nand Baba, he took out a laddu from his pocket and gave it to Krishna, and then slowly started untying the rope. So Gurudev explains that this rope was bound by Mother Yashoda, and even though many friends of Krishna tried to unbind him, to open the rope, like Madhu Mangal, Subal, Sridham and many other friends, but they were not able to open it because Vatsalya Ras is higher than Sakhya Ras. And since it was bound by Mother Yashoda, only Nand Baba was able to open it. So he asked him, who bound? Maya bound. And who opened? Baba. He opened the rope. So by this time Krishna's had slowly, he was not crying that heavily, but just taking some heavy sighing, and he was taking some, his breathing also was calming down. So Yashoda ji, she was standing at a far distance, but she could not muster the strength to come close to Nand Maharaj and Krishna, and she just kept watching them from a far distance. And she was also thinking, she was almost like a statue, and thinking, what if this tree would have fallen on Krishna? So she was very terrified. At that time, Nand Baba, he put Krishna on one shoulder and Balram ji on the other one, and took them to Brahman Ghat, where they bathed, and then finally they came back to the Goshala, and there he gave them some mishri in their mouth, and then directly from the udders of the cows, the stream of milk, straight into their mouth. So now, after drinking this milk, their bellies were full, and then they came inside the house. By this time, it also had become evening time, but the whole house was looking deserted. No one had cooked anything that day. And Mother Yashoda was just sitting on one side as if a wooden puppet. So they sat down in the kitchen area where they used to take prasad, and one side, on the left hand side, and the other side, Baldevji sat down. And by that time, Upanand's wife and Mother Rohini and other elderly gopis who were like mothers, they all had come, and they came to Krishna. And they were wondering that this is the situation of Yashoda, and if we don't take Krishna to her, then she would probably give up her life. So Rohini Maya asked Baldev to go and get Krishna and bring him to Mother Yashoda. When Baldev ji went to get Krishna, he pushed him very hard. And Baldev ji started wondering, oh, he's so strong, he was a younger brother, and how come he has so much strength that he's even pushed me? So then, after that, Mother Rohini and they all went to Mother Rohini went to Krishna and asked him that please come to Maya. So he said, no, I will not go. She said she is very, very sad, very distressed, but he refused to come. So she asked, who is going to feed you? Oh, Baba will feed me, and he will give me mishri and milk. And whom would you play with? With Dao Bhaiya. So like this he was saying, with all the arguments she was giving, he was not ready to come. So finally she said, oh, if you don't come, then she is going to Visihara, which means that she is just going to give up her body. As soon as Krishna heard this, he became overwhelmed and started crying with both his arms in the upwards, and he ran to Mother Yashoda and then sat in
front, Maya,
saying Maya, went to Mother Yashoda and sat in her lap. And she, who so far was just sitting as if a stone statue, she also started crying. And Nand Baba, seeing this, and Mother Rohini and Upanand's wife, all of them started crying. And so, Hare Krishna.
Itidrik Swalilabhi Rananda Kunde Sokasamanimajantam Akhapayantam Tadiyesi Tavkeju Bhaktai Nitattam. Here, in this way, Krishna, by whatever pastimes, he was singing all the gospels, whole Braj. There were so many pastimes, but Sukadeva Goswami saw that Parikshit will be only for 7 days, and mostly four, five days had been passed, only 2-3 days. So he, in brief, he began to tell. He has told about phal vikrayani. Fruit seller. Ramchandra will explain that history.
श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री वसुदेव गौर भक्त हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 यू नो It is very difficult to speak in front of, especially Srila Gurudev and so many advanced devotees. So, if I tremble, don't think I am humble. I am in trouble. And I pray at the lotus feet of Srila Gurudev from the core of my heart and pay my dandavat. Is accept what I say and help me. This fruit seller pastime is very briefly narrated in Srimad Bhagavatam. But Srila Gurudev many times explained very nicely, giving so many things in it. What are the most important things which we learn? A fruit seller belonging from Mathura, and Krishna was performing his pastime in Gokul. Very young boy, 2.5 years old. So sweet. But how this fruit seller came to know about Krishna? There were many ladies in Braj from low caste. They were making cow dung patties, cake, and selling the wood going from Braj to Mathura. And they went to fruit seller. They took their basket in their house, basket of kanda, means cow dung cake. Ari Mairi Have not you seen Krishna in Gokul? What is there in Krishna in Gokul? Very beautiful, very handsome, charming, so charming. What is in him? So every time she will come with Kanda and tell her, Krishna is very beautiful. Tad vidhi pranipaten paripashnen sevaya upadeshanti te jnanam jnanina tattva darshina. Those who have seen him, so they are listening from a person who has seen him. This is called start of bhakti, shravanam. They are listening about Krishna from them. Oh, and gradually desire evoke in her heart to see Krishna. Oh, I would like to see him. How does he look like? So what to do? Now I will sell my fruit in Braj. So let me go. I will do two things. I will sell my fruit and I will see Krishna. So she went. But all the fruits were sold in Mathura itself. Basket is empty. What to do? Should we go? Should she go or come back? So Gurudev says, when we advance in bhakti, bhakti is shubdha. Many good things will come. Prestige will come, money will come, ladies will come. And if we get involved, we'll come back. And then she decided, I will sell my fruits in Braj only, not in Mathura. Oh, little more sacrifice. Then she went to Braj. When she reached on the border, all the fruits are sold. Then, very difficult. Again, that lady came with Kanda. Oh, have not you seen Krishna? Oh, what to do? I used to go there, but my fruits are sold out. Oh, you foolish lady. You want to sell your fruit and see Krishna? No. Take all fruits for Krishna. Then you will see him. Now today, she has taken the fruits to give to Krishna. So, if we bring Krishna on priority, still we cannot see Krishna. When we can see Krishna, when we make Krishna only priority, only. Now today she went directly asking, where is the house of Krishna? At Nand Baba door, on his chabutra platform, she kept her fruit. She was thinking, she will give this fruit to Krishna. She is saying, oh, I will give this fruit to Krishna. Krishna will come and I will see him. Krishna, she's thinking Krishna. Now fruit is there. She wants to say, fruit lelo, fruit. Mango lelo, mango. But she cannot say like this.
Fallo,
fallo. Fallo, fallo. But she could not speak. She is thinking about Krishna. So fall was replaced by Krishna lelo. Govinda lelo. Madhava lelo. Not Madhava Maharaj. Madhava lelo. Damodar lelo. When the name is chanted by fruit seller from the core of his heart, Shuddhana, only for him, then Krishna came. He took a few grains in his hands, he gave. And he is coming. Grains are falling down. Only two or three grains remained in his hand, and he threw those grains in the basket of this lady. This lady is seeing Krishna coming. Oh my God, I heard from those cow dung petty seller from low class lady, but they could not really describe the beauty of Krishna. He is really so beautiful, more than what they described to me. This is the fact. In material world, whatever beauty we hear about any hero or heroine, but if they come in front of us, we will say, oh, this is the same which we saw in movie. But when it came in question of Krishna, however beautiful we may see, we may hold, but when we see practically, things are different. I remember once Srila Gurudev came to my house, and he saw all the pictures of Krishna I was having in my house, and I said, Gurudev, so beautiful. And Gurudev became very serious. He said, now no photo is so beautiful. Why? When you see, no photo is so beautiful. So she was so much stunned. When she saw Krishna's face, her eyes got stuck on face, on his eyes, on his lips. She could not move. Krishna then raised his hand. Maya, Kaldele, oh, you want fruit? Will you sit on my lap? Will you say my Maya? Krishna said, oh my God, Maya is inside the house. And she says, say me Maya. How can I do? He saw right, left, no Maya. Now, that Krishna who says in Gita, don't have attachment for fruit, and now he wants fruit. Fruit of love. And then he sat on the lap and said, Maya, and then got up. In a second, got up. And then she gave all the
fruit mud.
And then she started giving fruit. Small hands, childish hand, but all the fruits came in his hand. This is called Yoga Maya. That's a strange thing. He went away with those fruits inside his house. And this fruit seller, she kept on looking at him. She was totally lost. Her heart went with him. And Krishna gave all the fruits to Mother Yashoda. And Mother Yashoda distributed to everyone, and fruits are not finishing. Then she tried to pick up the basket. Basket was heavy, very heavy. Why it is heavy? She emptied it. Then she opened. She found it was full of jewels, diamonds, and so many precious stones. Now,